more comfortable. Anyway, it's that time of the week again, I'm afraid. Well, it's famous for 30 seconds. And who else? Yes, of course, the one and only Julian Ballantyne.
Tony Gregory, you're too kind. Yes, it is famous for 30 seconds. Now, people have told me, Jules, you're getting a little bit flash on a Saturday morning. We've got sports cars flying left, right and centre, and even had a truck here 2 weeks ago. So this week, there will be no trucks and no tricks. We're just going to take someone out of the street and make them famous for 30 seconds. I'd like to introduce you to the one and only Simon Smith. Simon, come in. As you all know... Now, Simon, as you can see, is one of two identical twins. But because I've met them before, I know exactly which one is Simon. So, Simon, what is it like being famous for 30 seconds?
No, I'm Mark.
A minor slip on a Saturday morning. However, I'm terribly sorry. Simon, how does it feel being famous for 30 seconds?
Actually, I'm Mark.
There's some minor confusion here, so what we'll do, we'll make you both famous for 30 seconds. So that means you're Simon.
Yes.
How are you?
All right.
And you're Mark.
Yes.
Are you excited?
Yes.
Are you sharing the excitement between you?
Yes.
Right, well, in that case, what I've got for you is a massive T-shirt, which is going to go over you both. So I want you both next to each other, real close. Go on, get close, and get in there and get your heads up there. And also, as always, oh, can you put your arm in there? That will do. We have for you some sunglasses. I think we'll rip those apart. Keep that one there. And you can hold that one there. And we've got a pen. And you can use this on Monday, Tuesday and Wednesday in your case, Thursday, Friday and Saturday in your case. How's that?
Thank you.
What have you got to say for yourselves?
It's great.
Mark and Simon Smith, you've been the best famous for 30 seconds we've had for a whole week. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Spin-off, what damage did the fire cause? Will Jimmy get his fingers burnt by the promises he made to Hillary? Why is Cesco so hot and bothered? Who is Lucinda carrying a torch for? And when a red-hot film director comes out shooting, will the sparks fly?
The main reception area from where I direct operations.
Hey, this is fine for the commercials. I'll set up my cameras here, and then I'll pan off your office there, across... Oh.
Oh, it's not actually my office. It's our manager's. But he's at head office on a course, learning how to prevent the fire caused by his son's cigarette.
He put the fire out straight away?
Yes, just a bit of papering to finish today, that's all.
That shouldn't affect the shoot, then. What's that through there?
That's our shop, offering a range of designer wear and handy mementos of your stay.
Who is that?
That's Lucy, Miss Cartier, our shop manageress.
I better check this out. Oh, yes. Yeah, ooh.
Watch this, then.
Yes, this is where it's at. Oh, this is perfect.
I'm glad you like it. We aim to please. Lucinda, may I introduce Zach?
Just Zach. Surnames are so bourgeois.
Really? Well, this is Lucinda Cartier. Lucinda, Zach, Zach, Lucinda.
Nice to meet you.
My pleasure, Lucinda.
Call me Lucy.
Lucy. That was my mother's name. I've always adored it.
Zach's here on a recce. That's film talk for checking out a location. He's going to bang off a commercial here next week.
Shoot.
He's going to bang off a shoot next week.
Shoot a commercial.
He's very busy.
Spin-off go card. Stay at any spin-off hotel at the turn of a card.
Not exactly Robert Rabbit.
Roger.
Cesco?
Roger Rabbit.
I prefer Cesco.
We'll try and make it interesting.
Sounds fascinating.
It's not all glamour, you know. There's a lot of hard work involved.
I'm sure there is. I bet you've got some wonderful tales to tell.
A few. Perhaps we could get together later.
That would be nice.
Goodness me, is that the time? We ought to get into the kitchen before Luigi starts preparing lunch.
I won't need to shoot in there.
Haven't you got customers to serve or something?
Not at the moment.
Good, good. We'll leave you to it, then.
I'll catch you later.
I look forward to it.
How about the potting shed? That'd make a nice location.
Relax, Cesco. I've seen all I need to see.
Surely not.
That girl in there, Lucy.
Yeah.
She's spoken for?
In what way?
Romantically attached. I mean, a pretty girl like that must have hundreds of boyfriends.
No. The money probably frightens them off.
Money?
Yeah, most of the men round here couldn't cope with the jet-set mob she's used to.
But you can.
Well, I'm more sophisticated, aren't I? Not that there's anything between me and her.
No?
No. I'm off romance at the moment.
Very wise. Listen, I need to make some calls. Can I use the...
Office, yes, of course. Feel free. More privacy.
Hey, yeah, right. Catch you later.
Yeah.
Do you believe in love at first sight?
What?
Zach. He's nice, isn't he?
He's all right. Bit flash.
Did you think so?
I'm just not at all sure a man his age would wear a jacket like that.
It's not like that.
Not like that, like that.
But he's not old.
Must be at least Hillary's age.
Well, I thought he was nice. I bet he's fascinating company.
They're all the same. Movie folk. Very shallow.
What have you got against him?
Nothing. I just know his type.
Well, if that's true, I wish you'd introduce more of them to me.
What was that? If those decorators have made a mess, I told Hillary, get a proper firm. But oh no, he lets Jimmy organise it, who ropes in some cowboy mates of his to do the job.
And you better see what they're up to.
It'll be chaos. You get what you pay for.
What's going on here? Oh, it's nothing. Just a wee accident with a non-drip emulsion.
We'll get it cleaned up. Here, thought there were meant to be two of you.
Okay, my pal Jock's off with his back.
Is he? Well, I hope you're going to get this finished on your own.
To be sure, and it's no trouble. I'll have it done in no time.
Yeah, just make sure it's done well. Oh, that ceiling looks rather nasty.
It's not that bad.
You ought to put on a thicker coat.
Oh, look, no thanks. I'm warm enough.
What's Jimmy let us in for this time?
Don't you worry about Jimmy.
He should have found you some more help.
You knew I could finish it on my own.
Mind you, I wouldn't put it past him to keep the money for the second decorator.
No. No. Jimmy wouldn't do a thing like that.
No. Of course he wouldn't. He'd keep the money for both.
Aye.
See you later, Jimmy.
Yeah, okay, Cesco.
You.
Hello, Cesco.
So Jack Nicholson said to me, Zach, he said, Zach, you're the best director I've ever worked with, but you're a real slave driver.
Amazing.
Well, that's Jack all over. Great actor, great human being.
What film of his did you direct? I might have seen it.
Well, I'm afraid not. That's the cruelest part. You see, it was never released. Great shame, great movie.
Great director.
Why, thank you kindly, missy.
So why aren't you still out in Hollywood? Surely they make more films there than here.
Well, three reasons. One, I believe passionately in the British film industry. Two, I won't play the Hollywood games to get a movie made. And three, well, never mind about three.
No, please go on.
It's just I've got this project of my own to make. The film I must make before I can die in peace. It's the story of a man who stays true to his art, who only paints what he believes in, not in what people will buy. But he ends up on the streets. When he dies of a broken heart, his wife seeks to destroy those who destroyed him.
Zach, that's quite a film.
It will be. In the meantime, I have to pay the rent for the spin-off gold card commercial.
I'm sure that'll be marvellous too.
I'll do my best. Listen, maybe you can help me.
Anything.
Ever done any acting?
Yes. I was ratty in Toad to Toad Hall at school.
Yeah, you've just got this great face. I'm sure the camera would love you.
I do believe you're flirting with me.
Am I? Listen, I know this is a bit risky, but then I'm that kind of a guy. I'm going to put you in the ad.
Really?
Really. It's just you've got this face that deserves to be preserved on celluloid forever. And we can work together closely. Very closely.
I'm not shouting loudly, Jimmy! I'm shouting softly. I'll start shouting loudly after I've lost my job!
You're upset, aren't you?
Upset?
I have an instinct about these things.
You have 15 seconds to tell me where the real decorators are.
Oh, there never were any. I kept both their wages and the money Hillary paid me for getting them. Or rather, not getting them.
You are making my second time in charge of this motel even more disastrous than the first.
Now that's impossible.
Hillary will kill you when he finds out.
If he finds out.
Jimmy, a word of friendly advice. Either that wall is finished on time or your career at the spin-off motel will be.
Yeah, everything's going like clockwork. It's a nice little setup. Nice people. Well, one in particular. And tell Stallone from me that... Yeah, but okay, well, get him or De Niro to call me back. Hey, where it is, man. Speak to you later. Early hours of the morning in L.A. You can buy a pizza, but you can't get an actor when you need one. Ah! You look a little steamed up.
Oh, it's glue.
Everything all right?
Just a little staffing problem with a little member of staff. Everything all right with you?
Yeah, it's fine. I've fixed up my dinner partner for tonight.
Lucy?
Yeah, I could really get serious about that one. She gives good vibes.
Really?
Oh, there is one thing. My rooms.
Is there a problem? You asked for a suite of three. Aren't they big enough or something?
Oh, it's not the size, it's the location. I mean, call me old-fashioned if you will, but I had expected three adjoining rooms with connecting doors. Instead, I find myself in 4, 21, and, 41.
That's impossible.
Well, maybe the girl who booked me in got confused. Sharon, her name is, isn't it?
Yes, easily bewildered. Dry rot in the basement, she's not well.
Well, it's no big deal, but it doesn't reflect too well on you, does it? Maybe I'd better mention it when I pop in with a finished film to head office.
No!
No?
Oh, I'll sort it out. I'll sort out everything. Excuse me a moment.
That leaves just 200 square metres of wall, which means I should be finished 2 days after Hillary has fired me again.
This is not a good day.
I think it is.
You've let me down, Jimmy. Sharon's let me down. But she's not here. So I've made a decision.
Oh, yeah? What's that?
You can choose. How I'm going to kill you!
Cesco, this really won't help matters.
It'll make me feel lots better.
In fact, I think this is the best day of my life.
It's the last day of Jimmy's.
Please, think about this logically.
Don't bleat, Jimmy. It's an undignified way to die.
Oh, I can help you. We can finish it between us if we try.
How does that help me? It's you that told Hillary you'd get it done.
And it's you he left in charge. Who do you think he's going to blame, eh? He's going to do both of us.
You're right. He's right.
I'm right.
I'm still gonna kill you.
Cesco, stop playing the fool. If we all muck in, Jimmy's right. We can get this finished.
Had a girl, Lucy.
Well, all right, then, so we can do it.
Right. I'll finish off this bit. You do that bit, Cesco, and Lucy can finish off around the door.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. I couldn't possibly slot paint about. I've got a date tonight.
Yeah, but you just said
best
that you...
Best of luck.
So Jack Nicholson said to me, Zach, he said, you're the best director I've ever worked with, but you're a real slave driver.
Zach?
Hey, I'll catch you later. Lucy, mia bella. I was just asking that young lady there where the best restaurant in town was so I could take the prettiest girl in town there.
Sounds dreamy. You can tell me more about your film.
Oh, a tortured soul. I find it very easy to talk about that. It's such a deeply personal statement, you see. It's about a man who ultimately sells his soul for love.
Is that you?
Oh, yes. I'd sell my soul for love for the right girl. Not that I've been lucky that way.
No?
I don't really want to talk about it. Oh. But I have scars, Lucy. Deep, emotional scars. It was only the movie that kept me going.
You poor thing. I'm going to have to take extra special care of you.
Well, I need more paste. I think there's something to start from.
Take a break, Cesco. Have some coffee.
Why not? Not going to get this finished before Hillary gets back anyway.
Chin up, you'll make it. Oh, did I tell you? Zach's given me a part in the commercial he's filming.
You like Zach, don't you?
He's the sort of man most girls dream about.
Sometimes a dream can turn into a nightmare.
Why should you be jealous of Zach and me? You have Mazzy.
You've got me wrong. I'm not jealous.
You're the last person in this world to lecture me, Cesco. Have you forgotten what a fool you made of yourself over my mother?
Rosemary, that was different. You've only known Zach a few hours.
I feel I've known him much longer.
He could be an axe murderer or something.
You're being ridiculous.
I'm just worried about you.
Worry about yourself and what Hillary's going to say.
Where's Lucy going?
To make a fool of herself.
Well, that's something you should be able to advise her on, eh? Grumpy, grumpy, grumpy.
So Jack Nicholson said to me, Zach, he said, you're the best director I've ever worked with, but you're a real slave driver. Now, let's see how you walk up those stairs, eh? Oh, yes. Very moving experience.
What is it, Zach?
Oh, nothing. Nothing that a few thousand pounds couldn't cure.
For what?
I can't raise the final loan to make a tortured soul.
But it's important. You've got to make that film, Zach. What will you do?
I don't know.
Maybe I could help. I've got some money.
No way. I wouldn't dream of touching your cash. There are other ways. I'll go make some calls now. Hey, it's not over till it's over, right?
We're gonna do it, Cesco. We're gonna finish on time.
Shut up and keep working.
Yeah.
Hello. Hillary? Oh, no, everything's fine. Jimmy just... I mean, the decorators Jimmy's employed are just finishing up. Oh, yes, everything's shipshape and Bristol fashion.
Ah! Let's go! Turn it off! Turn it off!
No, I don't know how to!
A tortured soul. Yeah, she's fallen for the sob story about the movie Hook, Line and Sinker. Yeah, she's absolutely rolling in cash. Soon it's all going to be mine.
Earlier, we asked you to ring us up with your alternative Christmas presents, and we've got on the phone Michael Thompson from Suffolk. Hello, Michael.
Hello.
Hello. What's your Christmas present, then?
Hairstyling machine.
A hairstyling machine? Why do you need a hairstyling machine?
Because every morning when I wake up, my hair's right of a mess.
Like, have you got short hair or long hair?
Well, fairly short.
Fairly short? So I wouldn't think you need a hairstyling machine.
Yeah, well...
All you need is a comb.
No, it's like a compost heap when I wake up.
A compost heap. Anyway, I think we've got you a present for that or something. What have we got?
Yeah, we've got this wonderful game as modelled by the wonderful Neil.
Is that all right, then?
Yeah.
Oh, we'll send you a T-shirt as well, mate, for having dodgy hair.
I think we should send you a hairbrush. Anyway, thanks for ringing, Michael.
Okay,
bye.
Bye-bye. Got problems with his hair.
Hair like brilliant. A compost teeth.
Listen, I've got a letter from someone else who's had a few problems here. Eleanor Garrett, she's from Cranbourne. She says, my horridest thing is being locked in a room full of 1,000 tarantulas for a whole year. Well, Eleanor, I've got some good news for you. There you go. They're on the way to you.
Oh, that's very nice. There you go. Oh, I've lost my letter. Put it down there. Right, I've got some jokes for you. From Heather Parks. What is green and white?
Don't know. Neil's breakfast.
Frog sandwich.
Yes, right.
Right, OK, I haven't seen this before. I've got a good joke, says Lisa Green. Two fleas coming out of a cinema. One says to the other, shall we walk or take a dog? What? Anyway, yes, very good. Here's Kim Wilde's brand new video. It's called Four Letter Word.
Well, I've got me twinkle toes on because in part five I'll be football training.